could hear you.
Thank you.
control.
Even monkeys.
Now I'm going to use the
Thank you for depositing 5 coins. Thank you for depositing 5 coins. You are attempting to trick Freddy! Thank you for depositing 5 coins.
Showtimes are on.
You are attempting to. Thank you for depositing 5 coins.
Thank
you for depositing 5 coins.
Yeah. You win some, you lose some. Yar, you play with.
Don't you hate getting...
fortunate. I'm gonna do a sneaky thing and throw a new contender in the ring.
Thank you for depositing 5 coins.
Yar, who touched me bird? Yar, what can I do for you?
Please deposit 5 coins.
My friend, you have met a terrible, terrible demise. But, I don't feel too bad about it. After all, if it weren't for me, it would have just been from someone else, you know? I guess what I'm trying to say is life goes on. Well, for everyone else, life goes on. Not for you. You're dead. But that's neither here nor there. It reminds me of one summer day in the park. I was having just a delightful picnic with my good friend Orville. And I said to him, Orville, I have a story. And he said to me, what's the significance of the story? And I said to him, Orville, not every story has to have significance, you know. Sometimes a story is just a story. You try to read into every little thing and find meaning in everything anyone says, you'll just drive yourself crazy. I had a friend do it once. Wasn't pretty. We talked about it for years. And not only that, but you'll likely end up believing something you shouldn't believe and thinking something you shouldn't think, or assuming something you shouldn't assume, you know? Sometimes, I said, a story is just a story. So just be quiet for 1 second of your life and eat your sandwich, okay? Of course, it was only then I realized I made sandwiches, and poor Orville was having such difficulty eating it. Elephants have those clumsy hands, you know? Actually, I suppose that's the problem. They don't have hands at all, do they? They're all feet. I couldn't imagine someone asking me to eat a sandwich with my feet. Now, if I recall correctly, there was a bakery nearby. I said to him, Orville, let me go get you some rye bread. Now, I'm unsure if elephants enjoy rye bread, but I assure you that Orville does. Now, this was on a Tuesday, which was good because rye bread was always fresh on Tuesday. They made sourdough bread on Monday and threw it out Wednesday, or rather, they sold it at a discount for people wanting to feed the ducks, and then probably at the end of the day, finally, they threw it all out. I don't recall. I do remember a man who would bring his son to the bakery every Wednesday and then go feed the ducks. He would buy all of the sourdough bread. Of course, you know, you're not supposed to feed the ducks sourdough bread at all. It swells up in their stomach and then they all die. At least that's what I've heard. You know, I never saw any ducks die myself, but I did notice a substantial decrease in the duck population over the course of a few years. I just never thought to stop the man and tell him that he was killing the ducks by feeding them sourdough bread. And if you want my opinion on the matter, and I told Orville this as well, if you want to feed ducks or birds or any kind for that matter, it's best to buy seed. I mean, when you think about it, breads of any sort don't occur in nature. They don't grow on trees or spring up from the bushes. I don't think birds know what to do with bread. What was I saying? Oh, yes. So I bought Orville some rye bread. What a fine day it was.